Hello and welcome back to Shakespeare. We are working on Titus Andronicus and insert gory play warning here. You've been warned there's going to be some gross stuff talked about in today's monologue and for the rest of the time that we're working on this play. But today we get to hear from Tamara at the end of Act 1, Scene 1. We're almost done with Act 1, Scene 1, which is the entirety of Act 1. It's really only one scene, and it's a doozy. Like, this is a play, a one-act play unto itself. Tamara herself started out as a prisoner, and then she had to plead for her son's life, but he was dismembered and burned and slaughtered anyway. And then Saturnius was named emperor and wanted to take Lavinia as his wife, but then Bassanius was like, no, we're already engaged, so he took her off to get married, and Titus, in trying to get her back so that she could marry Saturnius, ended up killing his own son, Mucius, and disavowing all of his other remaining live children, saying, you're no children of mine for dishonoring me so. And Saturnius decided that he doesn't need Lavinia anymore, but he's still kind of mad that Titus would have allowed such a thing to happen. But that's fine, because he marries Tamara, who he thinks is hotter anyway. And in yesterday's monologue, Tamara was begging for, well, not necessarily begging, but she was talking about how important it would be for Saturnius to forgive Titus. Because remember, Titus is a big war hero who came back to town after fighting with the Goths for so long, and now that she's empress, she sort of takes Saturnius aside. She did a big show of saying to everybody, you know, we're all gonna be friends, it's gonna be fine. But then she sort of, to the side, says to Saturnius, you know, it would be really stupid for you to do something to Titus right now. It's like your first act as emperor is to kill the one that they all wanted to be emperor. You should make up with him and then just leave it to me, because I'll find a time to kill him and his whole family, because he made me beg for my son's life in the street and then he killed my son anyway. So she's still very bitter, but she's putting on the regal empress face. And after her monologue yesterday, Saturnius is like, okay, fine, we forgive everybody. And Titus is like, you know, thank you, your words do make me feel better. And Tamara says to him, Titus, I am incorporate in Rome, a Roman now adopted happily, and must advise the emperor for his good. This day, all quarrels die, Andronicus. And let it be mine honor, good my lord, that I have reconciled your friends and you. For you, Prince Bassanius, I have passed my word and promise to the emperor that you will be more mild and tractable. And fear not, lords, and you, Lavinia. By my advice, all humbled on your knees, you shall ask pardon of his majesty. So this is a continuation of her show of being a good empress. She's like, you know, I'm a Roman now. I'm not a Goth anymore. I'm a Roman now. And so I have to help the emperor make good choices. So I'm declaring today is a day of peace for everybody. We're all just going to be friends from here on forward. And Bassanius, you're going to be less rash moving forward, and nobody has anything that they need to worry about anymore, Lavinia. So if you all just kneel down and ask for forgiveness, the emperor Saturnius will forgive you. So they all do, one by one. They kneel down and ask for forgiveness, and Saturnius is like, yeah, okay, this is fine, this is great, whatever. And Titus is like, how wonderful that we're all friends again, and your majesty, your emperorship, I'm going hunting tomorrow. You want to go hunting? And Saturnius is like, yeah, okay, cool, thanks. And that's the end of Act 1, Scene 1. So we've had a lot. We've had two murdered children. We've had two weddings. We've had like the verge of warring factions of Romans over who's going to be emperor. We had an election. We had a betrayal. And that's only the end of Act 1. So you can imagine where things are going to go from here. Or maybe you can't, because at the end of Act 1, Scene 1, everybody leaves except for Aaron the Moor, who has been there this whole time, but we haven't heard from yet. And we'll get to hear from him to kick off Act 2 tomorrow. I'll see you then. Mwah.